In this lesson, you will learn how to create basic metal materials with V-Ray and 3ds Max. Basic materials such as chrome, copper, and brushed steel are easy to create in V-Ray. Let's start by creating a standard V-Ray material for our chrome. Assign the material to an object. In the reflection section, set the color from black to pure white. The reflect glossiness controls the blurriness of the reflections. For regular chrome material with almost mirror-like reflections, we can set a value of 0.99. Let's see how it looked with blurred reflections. Whenever using a glossy value less than 1, noise starts to appear on the surface. By increasing the subdivision, we can get a cleaner result, but with longer render time. Sixteen subdivisions are fine for now. Another great way to control the looks of metallic reflection is the anisotropy effect. Set a value of 0.5 to 0.75 to get a brushed look. You can even control the rotation of the anisotropy. Our next material is copper. Assign a new V-Ray mat to a new object. The copper's color usually has some hue changes from different viewing angles. In the default diffuse color, you can only set one solid hue. So for this case, I'm going to use a falloff map in the diffuse slot. Now we can assign front and side color that will be visible according to the view angle. Our front color should be something between orange and brown. And for the side color, I'll copy the front color and give it a purple-pink tone. If you want, you can adjust the falloff angle by changing the curves. Something like that should be fine. Let's add some reflection with glossiness of 0.9 and IOR of 10. The reflect color should have more yellow-orange hue than pure white. Finally, set the highlights and glossy type to word. This looks better with metal materials. Our last material will be brushed steel. Assign new material with white reflect color. Check the Fresnel effect and set an IOR of 10. Set a default color of dark gray. Reflect glossiness of about 0.85 and BRDF type to word as before. Open the map tab and put a brush metal texture in the bump slot. Reduce the bump effect to about 5. To make the brush look more visible, we can copy the texture to the diffuse slot. The texture is a bit too bright. Click on it and add a color correction map. Reduce the brightness and bring the contrast up a bit. Reduce the reflection as well. That's much better.